Beloved, I'm so excited as I'm sharing this word because the Lord has given us revelation on how to practically enter into the realm of the kingdom of God. We were birthed into the kingdom by what Jesus accomplished on the cross, and the Holy Spirit ushered us in. When we were convicted of our sins, we repented. The Spirit of God entered into our lives and brought us into the kingdom. But then for years, we've been stuck in the kingdom. We haven't known how to release the power of the kingdom, how to move forward in the kingdom. That's what this mystery brings to us. It is a year of double fruitfulness. As I said yesterday, let God be true and every devil and every man and every circumstance a liar. We must stand on the authority of the Word of God to go forward. Our job is to take this word and do what it is saying. As I was giving in testimony, because the Lord himself brought this word to me in the financial area, and I started tithing when I was making less than minimum wage. I was living way beneath the poverty level. My God, if you make $6,000-$7,000 a year, that is beneath the poverty level. Do you hear me, beloved? And even at that time, God said tithe, and I obeyed. And then he came and asked me to sow a seed. Hallelujah. And the miraculous power of God broke out in my life. Supernaturally, I was able to live for 6 years, begging for nothing, asking nobody for anything, God working in my life. And when I roared out of it, hallelujah, the Bible says Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit out of the wilderness. When I came out of the wilderness, I came with a bang, hallelujah. And I went from making $6,000-$7,000 a year to making $40,000 a year. Boy, that's a roaring out. Come on, beloved. That was what, six times at least. My God, that is powerful. And then the new house came and everything came by the power of the kingdom of God released through seed. And that same miracle is what God is bringing to us in this year of fruitfulness. That same power of the kingdom coming forth by the seed sown in my life is what he's ministering to us. And the seed we are concentrating on, beloved, is the word of God. As I said yesterday, let me remind you, you cannot say you don't have the word. Yes, you do. You have some eyeballs, you have a Bible, and you can find the word. It's on TV, it's everywhere, but that's hearing it. But you sowing it is your responsibility. God will not undertake for your spiritual laziness. If you can stay up at night watching movies, you can stay up at night pacing the floor, reading the word out loud and sowing it into the soil of your life so it will take root. Let me read it to you again. And he said, so is the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground, until seed goes in the ground. The kingdom cannot start moving in your life. The kingdom cannot take root. Forget about prayer lines. Forget about chasing prophets. Forget about, you know, chasing after some miracle worker. This is how to work your miracle. This is how to produce your own miracle, to unleash the force of the kingdom in your own life. A man must put a seed in the ground. And beloved, the moment you sow the word of God into your life, now it's time for you to go to sleep. There's no need to worry anymore. There's no need to be anxious anymore. There's no need to fret anymore. There's no need to be restless anymore. There's no need to be sleepless anymore. He says you go to sleep, you rise night and day. Watch this. He said that seed will spring and grow up, and you will have no idea how it happened. Wow, beloved, that's a miracle. That releases me from performance. That releases me from being responsible. I should take the seed of the word of God and speak it, and speak it, and speak it to get into my heart. My heart is the soil. My heart is the ground. My heart is the prepared ground for the Word of God. And we will get into it. Beloved, it is our responsibility to speak the Word of God to our generation. The believers all around this country are compromising. We are talking tolerance. We are thinking tolerance, accommodation, everybody getting along. Beloved, that is the message of the Antichrist. Jesus Christ came bringing a sword. Jesus Christ came unleashing a kingdom that's opposed to the kingdom of this world. He said to Pilate, "My kingdom is not of this world." Hallelujah. And we are in that kingdom. And listen to the book of Hebrews. We have received a kingdom which cannot be moved, a kingdom which cannot be shaken, a kingdom which can never be defeated. That is this kingdom. He's telling us how to unleash in our lives by the power of the Word of God spoken into my life. That's why I'm excited about it. That's what brought me out of the wilderness I was in several years ago. And that is what is propelling me into my next level in the ministry, into my next level in my destiny. And I'm trying to bring you into it, beloved. Get your Bible out and start sowing the Word of God. You will not remain the same. That's why I'm inviting you to join us for the Resurrection Parade on the 31st of March. Join us on the 30th of March at the steps of the Capitol when we are making decrees and praying on behalf of this state and this nation. God will answer us. We shall see miracles. Join us after the parade. We're going to the Olympic Park once again to rally and to preach the gospel. Oh, beloved, Atlanta will not remain the same as we keep at it, trusting God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you.